In this video, we will discuss user groups and how they can be beneficial to you and those you work with. In addition, we will discuss the steps needed to create and properly request access to a user group on the Fulton Supercomputing system. The Fulton Supercomputing Lab offers file sharing groups as a service to all of our users. Research groups often want to share code, datasets, and other output files with each other to better facilitate collaboration within the group. The best way to do this is through the creation of a file sharing group. A file sharing group allows a user to share his or her files with other users on the Fulton Supercomputing system. These users may be coworkers, mentors, or other researchers who require access to your data. Through the use of a file sharing group, users with access can create and modify files shared in this space. User groups are given two locations for storage. The first is a home directory, which is backed up and currently has a default storage quota of 40 gigabytes. This is where all of your data will be stored while it is not being used to run jobs on the supercomputer. You can request additional space in the home directory by opening up a support ticket on the FSL website. Each request will be evaluated on a per-need basis. The second directory is a compute directory, which should be used to run all of your jobs. It is important to note that the compute directory is not backed up, and space is limited, so please remember to remove and back up any data that is not currently being used for processing. When a user is given access to a group, a new directory labeled FSL_groups will be added to their current home directory. Within that directory will be a list of all the groups that particular user has access to. It is possible for a user to have access to multiple groups. Now let's go to the FSL website and create a new group. Navigate to marylou.byu.edu. Log into your user account. Select My Account. Select File Sharing Groups. Select Create Group. From here, all you have to do is enter a group name and select Submit. That's all there is to it. Within a few minutes, a new FSL_groups directory will be added to your account's home directory. If you are the group owner and you would like to add users to your group, navigate to the My Account section of the FSL website as previously instructed. Select File Sharing Groups. From there, you will see a list of groups for which you are currently the owner. Select the group you wish to modify. At the bottom of the screen, you will see a button labeled Add User. Simply type the name of the user you would like to add and press Add User. If you wish to remove a user from a group, check the box next to their name and select Remove Selected Users. To request access to another user's group, simply contact the group owner and he or she can add you to their group. It is important to note, when developing scripts using the PBS script generator, you must check the box marked I am in an FSL group. Failure to do so will prevent other users in your group from accessing and modifying your job output, regardless of whether they are in your group or not. We hope this video has been helpful in helping you understand more about the supercomputer and file sharing groups. If you have any questions or encounter any problems, feel free to contact one of our system administrators by opening up a support ticket on our website.